Greetings, greetings out there. Greetings, greetings. I greet you in the name of Jesus because He is the only one we need in this planet to survive. He is the only one we need. So for those whom it is their first time watching this video, I can say to you, welcome to my channel. Welcome to this platform where the word of God has been shared to people, the people who are in need, who need help, the people who need to be helped by this word, which is the word of God. We need the word of God in order for us to survive. So my name is Mr. Matebula. For those who don't know me out there, my name is Mr. Matebula, who will be sharing the word of God with you, who acts as a direction to the nation, because people are lost, are being led astray by so many things. We have so-called false prophets. We have so-called people who are demonic possessed, leading in our nation. But in the public, they appear to be saints, but behind the closed doors or behind the scenes, they perform rituals, they perform many things which are contrary to the word of God. So today I will be dealing with the topic of how exactly how to be born again. How to be born again. So this video for today is going to be one of our shortest video. One of our shortest video. Meaning I will be taking people through the steps of how to be born again. First of all, I know that some of you are confused out there. They don't know what the definition of being born again is. Being born again, a short definition of it, is being born of God. Why to be born of God? Because of being born of God, it is an act. It is an act of receiving Him through the Spirit and in truth. Why we have to be born again? We have to be born again in order for us to take the glory back to us, because the glory, it was lost in the Garden of Eden by Adam and Eve. That glory need to be taken from us. Everyone who comes to this earth, he or she comes to this earth with a sin, which was then yet committed by Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden. So it is the choice of every living being to be born of God, meaning we didn't choose to be sinners, but we choose to be born of God. So here is a trick. Being born again, another definition of being born again is an act of receiving God and allowing Him to be your Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Allowing Him to guide you through the paths of this earth, through the journey of this earth, because many things are happening, some of which are taking our attention away from the word of God, away from the mission which God has called us to do here on earth. Every man was created to worship God. Meaning that's why you see most of the people are being depressed, suicidal, confused in this earth. Why? Because of they are trying to run away from the truth. They are trying to act as if truth must replace lies, and lies must be in the position of the truth. But that won't happen. Truth cannot replace lie. Lies cannot replace truth. But truth can push away. But where truth is, truth can push away lie. Because truth can push away lies. Because truth act as a lie. Lies act as darkness. Where truth is, there is lie. Where lies are, there is darkness. Meaning we need to know God in this earth. We were created to worship Him. We were created to know Him. We were created to be one with Him. We were created to allow Him to enter, to come within our hearts and be our Lord and Savior. So here, let us navigate through the steps of how to be born of God. The first thing that we must do to be born of God, we have to accept that we are sinners. We have to accept that we are sinners. That is the first step of being born again, being born of God. You have to accept that you are a sinner through the Spirit. You have to accept that you are a sinner, meaning the first step of being born again is acceptance. You have to accept that you are a sinner. You have to accept that you have been led astray by the things of this earth. You have to accept that you are a gossiper. You have to accept that you are a murderer. You have to accept that you are a rapist. You have to accept that you are watching porn, and porn is not good for you. You have to accept that you have jealousy. You have to accept that you have any other kind of sin that is in earth, that is in this earth. You have to accept that you are homosexual. You have to accept that you are a cheater. You have to accept that you are a thug. You have to accept that you are a gang member and you want to come out of that life that you are practicing or that you are in it. You have to accept that you have wronged other people. You have to accept that you have been you have led other people astray. You have to accept that you are unforgivable. You have to accept that you have been masturbating all along before knowing Christ. You have to accept that you are a prostitute. You have to accept that you have left the children. You have to accept that you have been controlled by anger. You have to accept that you have been doing all these wrong things to other people. Meaning, first step of being born again is acceptance. You accept your mistakes. So in simple vision, you have to accept your mistakes. You have to admit our second our second step of being born again is that you have to admit that you have been doing, you have been practicing all those things. You have to admit that you have been practicing all those things, and those things are not good for yourself. You have to admit it. Admit. So our third step, you have to go to God and ask for forgiveness through prayer and supplication. You have to go to Him and tell Him all of those things that you have accepted that you were doing, which were wrong to you. You have to accept, you have to go to Him and ask Him that, Father, I come to you today. Go to your secret place and tell Him, Father, I come to you today. I come to you with this sin, with this sin of jealousy, with this sin of gossip, with this sin of masturbating, with this sin of watching porn, with this sin of homosexuality, with the sin of gluttony, with the sin of raping, with the sin of murdering, with the sin of prostituting, I come to you, God, and I accept that I am a sinner. And I accept that I am a sinner. Please, God, take away the sin. Take away. I allow you to take away these sins that are bothering me. I allow you, God, to lead me. I allow you to enter into my heart because you are my Savior. I believe that you died on the cross. I believe that you died for my transgressions. I believe that you saved me from these things that I was doing. I believe that, God, this thing, this sin of lust, this sin of masturbating, this sin of homosexuality, this sin of cheating, this sin of murdering, this sin of raping, it has been taken away from me. Go to God and ask Him. He will forgive you. And those things will be taken away from you. They won't be instantly taken away from you. Born again, it is a process. It is a process. It requires a process. For some, it takes. There are no prescribed years on which God has prescribed that someone must be born again within those particular years. But it is a process. It depends on an individual that what are you doing within the process? And what are you doing along the process? When you are really eagerly, when you eagerly have that desire to take away that thing that is bothering you during the process, when you pray each and every day, pray in the morning, pray when that thing is in your mind, when you think about it, when you breathe about it, that you want to leave this thing, God will rescue. This God is very wonderful. He's wonderful. He is wonderful. He can take away everything away. He can take everything away from you. He can take it away from you. Then go to God, read the way, study the word of God, pray, worship Him. Worship Him each and every day, because that is what activates us as living beings. That is what take away. That's the step that take away all those things that are suffering us, that are bothering us. And take away that suffering away from us through praise and worship. When we pray to Him each and every day, and reading His word, meditating to this word, thinking about Him every day and every night, and we will be saved from everything that we are suffering from. We will be saved depending on what we do during the process. When we read the Bible, meditate the way, because the word of God is power. The word of God acts as power to us. It heals us. It protects us from any other bondages of sins. During your prayer, call unto Jesus. Call unto Jesus. Worship Him. Worship God in spirit and in truth. Don't just worship Him. Worship Him in spirit and in truth. Because that is the thing which is required from us, to worship God in spirit and in truth. We have to seek Him as our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We have to seek Him in the day, seek Him in evening, seek Him during the evening, seek Him during the night, seek Him every day. So by going to God and asking Him that, please God, take away this pride, take away this sin of lust. I've been lusting after women. I've been stealing. Please God, take away this sin away from me. And willing and just to take the cross and following Jesus Christ. For you to be born again, you don't just wake up in the morning and say that I want to be born again. You go to God and ask Him that, God, I really want to be born again. I'm tired of this sin. I'm tired of this thing that is destroying me within. Go to God in a secret place. If it is difficult to do that thing, for those who don't attend church out there, please seek your nearest church. Seek the nearest church where you will go and fellowship and feel the presence of God, and ask the elders to assist you out there. If they assist you, also pray during your spare time at home. Pray to God, ask God that those people that you are, those people whom they are helping, are they really real people or they are not? So go to God and ask him through supplications. Ask God, because many are at church to deceive the nations. So be careful of those kind of people where you seek help from. But trust God more than any other people. Trust God any other individual. Trust God more than anything. And He is willing and just to take away the sin that is bothering you, the sin that you are suffering from, the sin that is destroying you, that does not give you rest. Call it during prayer to God, crying to God. It is legal to cry to God, because God is our Father. It is legal, not illegal, but legal to God to cry to Him. Crying to Him every day and every night. And through worship, God will take away that thing you are suffering from out there. God will protect you. God will guide you. God will rescue. Because those who are rescued by God are free indeed. We are free indeed, those who are rescued by God. We were also sinners. We admitted that we were sinners to God. We admitted that we practiced sin. Don't see us as innocent as we are today. We are coming from deepest muddy clay, where we were taken by God, where there is no life, where there was no life there, where it was difficult to even take a breath, where it was difficult to take a breath. But God, we searched for God with all our hearts, and we found Him. Here we are today, standing and proclaiming His victory. We say victory. Victory is His name. No other God but Jesus. No other God but Him alone. Because He knows everything that is destroying us. He can heal our hearts. He heal the hearts of the brokenhearted. He healed the brokenhearted. He healed those who are sick. He healed those whom earth has altered the way that they won't be able to make it again. But through His grace, through His power, nothing can surpass the power of God. Nothing can surpass the power of God. Nothing. Because the power of God is great. It's greater than any other thing that you may think of in this earth. It is a necessity for us to be born again, because being born again is a requirement for us to see the kingdom of God, to see heaven, to worship Him with angels out there. After that, after death, because after death there is another life. After death there is another life where we will worship with our God in spirit and in truth. God bless you all. Till next time.